Hello class, today we are going to discuss a new concept from minute number 5. The concept name is interface. We have already discussed the different types of inheritance in Java, namely single inheritance, multi-level inheritance and hierarchical inheritance. We have discussed one assignment on hierarchical inheritance. Now it's time to discuss one more flavor of inheritance in Java, and that is nothing but what? Multiple inheritance. So what we are aware about multiple inheritance in C++? Is we have multiple base classes and one derived class involved. Such kind of implementation we refer it as multiple inheritance. Now in Java, directly with the help of classes, it is highly impossible to implement multiple inheritance. Hence, a new concept we require to integrate in the program, and that new concept is nothing but what? Interface. So in today's session we'll discuss what exactly the meaning of interface, how to define it, how to extend the interface, then how to implement that interface, and we'll discuss one program on the same. So in the introduction I'm having the slide for inheritance first, and then down line we'll discuss interface. So what we are aware of inheritance in Java, it's a concept of reusability. Two different types of classes are involved. The class which has already been present or which is already defined, we call it as base class or super class or parent class, and the new class that we want to define with the help of existing class, we call that new class as a derived class or subclass. We have already discussed the syntax of defining subclass in Java. Once again we'll revisit the same, and based on how many super classes and how many subclasses we have in the implementation in Java program, we have types of inheritances like single inheritance, multi-level inheritance and hierarchical inheritance. So this is the syntax of subclass definition in Java. So in the syntax we must need to specify from which superclass it has been extended by using keyword extends. So in Java we have this data types classification. Now today's topic is interface. Now where it lies? It lies under non-primitive category next to classes. So it's a non-primitive. The meaning of non-primitive means you can divide it further without changing its meaning. So it's a non-primitive kind of data type available in Java. Interface is the keyword. So like classes, interface consisting of interface members. So there are two types of interface members available. The members which represent information part, we call them as data fields, and the members which represent attribute behavior part, we call them as methods. So attributes are nothing but what? Data fields, and behaviors are nothing but what? Methods. So in interface we can achieve the abstraction. How? Soon you will come to know through the definition of interface. So for example, I'm having a syntax of interface definition here. So the syntax of interface definition is, it starts with keyword interface, then next to that name of interface, and in that you'll have to specify the data fields and methods. So data field means the information part or attribute part of interface body, and methods are nothing but what? Behavior part of interface body. So here in case of class body, we used to define methods inside the class body only, but when it comes to interface body, we have to declare. We can't define methods inside interface. The methods of interface are always declared or they are always abstracted. Hence this point number 2 is, in case of Java we can achieve the abstraction by means of interface. So the methods are abstracted. In the class also we have methods abstracted. We call such kind of class as abstracted class. But in case of interface, it is mandatory that what not methods it has in it, all are abstracted only. So interface is the keyword, as I said, and here the name of my interface is interface name only, so it can be any valid Java identifier. So now the syntax of interface data field and interface method. So data field syntax will start with keyword final, then next to that we will have to specify the type of data that data field will going to support. So here the data type, next is the name of that data field, and you must have to initialize it. Remember, in case of class, we never initialize data field in the definition of class, but when it comes to interface, initialization of data field of interface is mandatory, and having final keyword is also mandatory. Inside its syntax only it has been specified. When it comes to method of interface, you can't define it, but you must have to declare it. So the declaration syntax remains unchanged. The syntax says you must have to specify return type, name of the method, and parameters if required. So here, through example, we'll discuss. So I'm having the interface for area. Area is the name of interface. So first data field is pi of type float, which is final, and the value that I'm assigning to pi is 3.14 in the definition itself. Now I'm having two methods, one is compute and one is display. Both are abstracted, both are declared. Nowhere body of the compute and display method is available. So the syntax of method declaration is its return type, name, and parameters. So here method name is compute, its return type is float, and two parameters, both are of type float, I required. Next method is having return type void, name of the method is display with no argument or no parameters. So this is what the example of definition of interface area. Now, like in case of class, we can extend a class into a new class to ensure effective utilization of memory. That part we discussed under inheritance. In the similar fashion, we can extend one interface while defining a new interface. So it's like we can have super interface and sub interface concept. So here I'm having the example of the same. Through syntax we'll discuss first, and then downline I'm having example. So here interface name 2 I want to define, and I want to take help of some interface members belongs to name 1. So here name 1 is already defined interface. I'm utilizing its members. That members may be data fields of type final or abstracted methods while defining name 2. So I'm taking help of name 1 for defining interface name 2. So with the help of extends we can do that. So this is also a kind of inheritance in case of interface. So I can say that I'm extending name 1 properties inside name 2. So in case of interface also this extend keywords works. So when it comes to extends, we can refer name 1 as super interface and name 2 as sub interface. So the same I have explained under this bits. Now example of extending interface, I'm having interface PICT having only two data fields of type final. First is of type string department with name with value ENTC, then number of students, let's say 100. Second interface is details, I want to print them. So here this interface is free from method. So you can have interface with only data fields or interface with only methods. So it depends on your application. So in this case I have considered PICT interface having only data fields and details interface which acts as a sub interface for super interface PICT having display methods. So this display will print department as well as number of student details which got extended inside this details interface. One more example. So in the previous slide I was having one super interface and one sub interface. Here I'm having two super interfaces and one sub interface. So here first super interface is atom constants, second one is atom methods, and third one is only atoms. So here first super interface consisting of two data fields, code of type integer and name of type string with some initial values. Next interface is atom methods. So there is no relation between atom constant interface and atom method interface. Both are independently defined. But when you start defining atom, you must require to extend the members of atom constant interface as well as atom method interface by using keyword extend. See how I'm defining interface atom, which is my sub interface. So while defining this sub interface, I'm taking help of earlier existing two interfaces which acts as a super interfaces, and I'm separating them with comma. Okay, by default access specifiers available for interface members are public. In case of class in Java, we have default, private, public, protected, but in case of interface, it is always need to be public. So please do remember that interface data fields are final. You must have to initialize them while defining interface, and once you initialize them, later you can't change. Okay, so we have discussed with extending interface. So you can extend super interface while defining sub interface with the help of keyword extends. Now, as you know, although we are extending super interface members in sub interface, still we can't define the methods which are available in super interface inside sub interface or the methods of sub interface. So we must required to implement those methods. So for implementing those methods, we need one entity, and that is nothing but what? Class. So class will take responsibility to define abstracted methods or declared methods of interface. So under the title implementing interface, we'll discuss that part. So interface are used as superclasses whose properties are inherited or extended by classes. So such classes we can refer as subclasses. So syntax for the same is, here the class name is class name, interface is having name interface name. So this interface is already defined with abstracted methods, because in the syntax only we discuss, we can't define methods in interface, but somewhere we need to call them, and before we call them, we must have to define them. So this class will take responsibility, this class will take responsibility to define abstracted methods from interface, because in the definition of class syntax we discuss, we can define methods in class. So class methods are defined. Okay, so this class will take responsibility. So how you will come to know that? Because in a program we do have multiple interfaces and multiple classes. So which class takes responsibility to define abstracted method of which interface? To get that or to figure out that, we can observe this syntax. So this syntax picks lots of the thing, like this particular interface gets implemented using this class. So this keyword implements comes into the picture. So when we move from class to class, we require extends. When we move from interface to interface, we require keyword extends. But when it comes to interface to class, just for defining abstracted methods of interface, we must require to implement the same using the keyword implements. Okay, so extends and implements are two different keywords which are newly introduced under the topic Java interface and Java inheritance. The same as I already discussed, class to class extend, interface to interface extend, and interface to class implements. What about class to interface? Class to interface, which is not allowed, because class can have defined method. So how you can extend or how you can implement that class using interface? So that is not allowed. Do remember this. So in case of sometimes in oral, they used to ask, like, if I'm having A of type interface, B of type class, then which keyword I require to move from A to B? So here assume that B acts as a class to define abstracted methods of interface A. So obviously we required implements. I have written it in short, but please read it as implements. If I'm having C as again of type class, then I need extend method, because B here is a class. So class to class extend, interface to interface extend, and interface to class implements, class to interface not allowed. So A is the class. If B is also a class, then you required extends. Here parallelly, D is the interface, and if E is again interface, then you required extends. From E to B, B is class type and E is interface type, so you need implements. Finally, you have class C, so you want to define class C with the help of class B, you need extends. So here hierarchical representation, A is interface, B is class, and D is also a class, so you need implements in both the cases. Here it is multiple inheritance, multiple interfaces, and here A and B both are interfaces, C is also an interface, so you need extend. Down the line, D will take responsibility. So D is of type class, so we can have implements keyword here. So in this case, D will take responsibility to define abstracted methods from all interfaces available before it. I mean to say, if you have some abstracted methods in class A, class B, class C, D is there for you. Now through example we'll discuss this. Interface area is defined with one data field and one method which is abstracted. Now next, class rectangle and class circle. Both the classes are taking responsibility to define compute method. So you can define or you can implement this method of interface inside a program using multiple classes. So here what you record altogether is specify it through implements. So here this class acts as a subclass and this area acts as a super interface, or sometimes we call it as a super class as well, because interface is again a kind of class only having data fields of type final and methods are abstracted. So here the method of interface area compute gets defined using class rectangle. Same method once again I am defining inside class circle. Okay, so here I am writing the formula to calculate area of rectangle. I am returning, and here I am returning, in case of circle I am returning area of circle formula, the value. Then the next one more class which is independently defined just to hold main method, hence the source code name will be interface test.java. Here I have specified that. So here I am declaring objects of two classes, class rectangle with name rect and class circle object with name cir. Now as these two classes are taking help responsible to implement compute method of interface area, so I can access that method using those two objects appropriately with the call rect.compute in bracket 10, 20. So I will be getting area of rectangle. Similarly, I can be in a position to observe area of circle by calling cir, which is a circle type object reference, dot compute. Accordingly, I'll send the value and I can be in a position to get that. Okay. Then how do we achieve multiple inheritance in Java? So in the beginning only I said with the help of classes you can't. So you must require class and interface combination. So this is also a kind of representation. I mean, you can have all interfaces for representation of multiple inheritance, but here methods are abstracted, so you must require a class to implement those methods. So here in the first implementation I have shown it through class. So interface, two super interfaces and one subclass. So implements we required. In this case, two super interfaces, one sub interface, hence extends. So here two super interfaces I am having with me, interface printable with method print and interface showable with method show. Class A will take responsibility to print. I mean, class A will take responsibility to implement print as well as show method of interface printable and interface showable respectively, but you must have to make sure that class A is the subclass of these two interfaces with the help of this syntax. So class A implements printable comma showable, definition of print, definition of show, and then down the line one independent class, class multiple underscore inheritance, a main method is defined, object of class A is declared. Then obj.print, it will print the message which is available in print method, and then obj.show, the message available in show method. So this is how you can achieve multiple inheritance in Java. So this is what all about the concept of interface in Java. Thank you.